Alright, guys, welcome back to America's Bee. It is Saturday, August 7th, at about 12:30 in the afternoon. And today, I have an awesome treat. We are going to bust into this barrel hive after roughly 2 months of just letting them do their thing. I did a mite check on them a while ago, and they had a zero count. And so we're going to do another mite check on them today. And we're going to address some cross comb and get them set for fall and winter, and check on the numbers, check on the queen. With the amount of bees that is in here, I would be surprised if they had swarmed or anything, but they are bringing in a lot of pollen still. I think it's sunflowers and some clover, some nice Cheeto colored, some whitish tan colored pollen, and some others. And hang out, relax, come on in and take a look at this pollen here. All right, before we get started, I have a spray bottle of 1-to-1 sugar syrup with some Honey Bee Healthy, about a teaspoon per quart or so in here. And I'm gonna give them a spray. I do have smoke available. I'm gonna see what I can get away with. I will be fully suited with my top and veil, just because I have a feeling we're gonna be getting them pretty stirred up today with their cross comb that they're gonna have. I am going to try two different remedies, some popsicle sticks on the bottom of the frames, and also some string with some wax on both. And I'm going to, see how they compare on how they draw out each one. I'm trying to get them to draw it straight out. And as of now, there is some that kind of crosses. And I think unless it's brood, I do have some rubber bands I'm prepared to band into some frames. But for the most part, I'm just probably gonna, if it's honey, wax, or anything like that, I'm just gonna get rid of it unless it's some valuable brood. And I may take that and go put that in a different colony who needs some help. So let me give them a little spritz here just to kind of calm them here. I didn't like that. There we go. Keep them busy. So, all right, let's go ahead and dive right on in here. Not sure what you can see here, but if you look closely, you'll see some baskets coming in, and it's coming in pretty good. I don't think there's two right there. Three, four, five. Six right there. I don't think we've really ever slowed down. We slowed down a little bit a couple weeks ago, maybe a month or so ago. It seemed like it slowed down, but it, maybe a couple days worth. They're bringing in sunflowers. There's a lot of stuff blooming still. There's some light colored yellow stuff. Anyways, let's go see what's going on inside. All right, you saw the front of the entrance. They're bringing in a lot of pollen. I don't know how much nectar is out there. I'm not feeding them. I have the wrapped around feeder on, but let's bust in here and see what we're looking at. All right, so let's see if they clean this out. Little bit left in here, so, and this has been on for a few months, so they're just not taking it. Put this off to the side. Give them a little squirt there. I think at this point, I'm just gonna have you come a little closer. Okay, just give them a little puff of smoke here. Now I'm gonna start on the back side here because this is the farthest side away from the entrance. All I do think they have some, quite a bit of room in here still, which is real nice. And I'm gonna take this and that guy right there. A little bit of some room here. This is was an empty wire frame, which is not touched yet. Okay, so that means that they have plenty of room to work with here. Now I do have an extra deep box that I'm going to be taking and putting. I'm going to do 10 at a time, and then I'm going to fix the bottoms with some either string and some wax, or some hot glued popsicle sticks with some wax to encourage them to draw straight when they do get to these frames. So here is a better comb, and they're all over here, so they're all over this place patrolling it nicely. And they are storing this with some nectar, which is great. Flip it around here, and they have quite a bit of nectar honey in there. Now this side is, you can see how they kind of have just one little row there, because it does have a wood brace back there. They really don't have access to some of this comb, and that's just kind of the design of the barrel, one of the flaws. But it's fine, because they work around it, and that is some nice comb in there. Let's see what this guy is. This is another wire foundationless, and it is untouched. Another wired foundationless. Now that I have some more foundation, plastic foundations, I may replace some of those wireless with plastic foundations. So as you can see on this one, there's nothing. They did draw a little bit on the very top, but I wouldn't even consider that drawn really, if I was really paying attention. All right, the next frame is looking much better. This is again a wired foundationless, and they have drawn out a little bit here, and there is nothing in there, so they're probably just working on this. This one, and we're really starting to see some good stuff here. The plastic foundation that is probably a good 60% drawn out here, 50-60%. They are storing nectar in there, which is really good. And they are starting to draw this side out over here. Now, I did not add any additional wax to this other than what was already there. I'm gonna keep these on the frames for now, just so that they can somewhat guard the nectar in there. All right, here's some more better comb here, and it was attached a little bit to the comb next to it, which is again another better comb, and this one's heavy.
Oh, wow.
Full of honey.
Should
absolutely full
bottom area you want the dicks.
So this is basically what I'm talking about. This one's not as bad, but again, it's just it's off center, and it really makes it difficult to manipulate these frames in and out of this barrel. Here's the back side. They're almost done capping. I mean, this frame's...
Bring your frame down.
Easily... Like that?
Yep.
This frame is easily close to 15 pounds. And I think a lot of it is because this better comb is thick and there's a lot more space than a plastic foundation. And they really do a good job of filling this stuff out. You see some of that there? They're getting a nice little treat. I might steal some from them later. Now, as far as anything in this comb, I don't see anything. And so I'm going to just get rid of it.
Should we do that when we go to fix it, or are you gonna do it now?
No, I'm gonna do it now because it won't fit in the thing.
Do you want me to go open the cooler box?
No, there's not honey or anything in there, so. All right, I'm gonna put this in my wax jar. There's a little bit of nectar in there, but nothing I'm too worried about. I have a feeling we haven't even touched the surface of the craziness that I'm anticipating on here. So this one is another better comb here. They are storing nectar in there, and this side here is probably 99% capped. I uncapped a little bit of it, which took some of that away.
Okay, you can go ahead and bring it up now.
All right. Now, you do have to be careful with this stuff because of... the fact that this is still really brittle comb, and it's not real hot out here, but contemplating on what I want to do with this guy, angled off a little bit. I think I'm gonna leave this frame for now, just because it's for the most part pretty center. Wow, and it's just full of honey. All right, let's see what this next one. Down in there. It does feel like it's frost a little bit on something. Definitely something breaking down there. Alright, so again, this is a plastic foundation that, at least on this side, is completely packed. And, you know, this is probably an example of one that I'm going to cut off because it's pretty far off. I mean, well, maybe it's just that side. But anyways, that's some nice honey there that I may just treat for myself and my family. All right, so this side, clearly, they didn't get the memo that they needed to finish it, but they are... drawing the foundations out there, and so they are working on it. That capped honey there is pretty shallow, and that should probably, they'll be able to fill that out real quick like so. What I'm gonna do is just give it a shake here. Now, this next frame down in here is when it really starts getting funky. And look at all that nice honey on there. What I'm gonna do is just scrape this off of these grills here. There. Pop this cap here, I think. Checking for the queen, and I don't see her up here, which is real nice. You can see all the propolis and bridge comb and whatnot that they have done up here, which I'm just gonna watch out, girls. Take care of this stuff for them here, because. Yeah, don't want to squish it like that. That corner stuff I don't care about, but this stuff will go into the spare wax bucket here. Put this off to the side. All right, you see here my experimental treatment. Looking real nice. See what our mite loads are like. Let's put this over here actually. Alright. This is when they start getting all worked up here. Yeah, big old chunk just came plopping off, which is okay. As you can see how crooked that stuff is, and you know it's not their fault, they're just doing the best they can, but this frame is a, what is this, this was just a wired foundationless frame, and it is just full of honey. This would be a nice one to make cut comb on. It is pretty looking. There's some wax down there. So let me go take care of all this stuff real quick. Actually, I'm gonna shake these girls off. Any bees that get stuck down in there will come out later.
Why'd you choose to use the cooler to put the honey in?
First off, it has a lid, and then it will help keep the honey cool a little bit. All right, so this is our 10th frame here. 10. So I'm going to just briefly put these covers back on that one. I'm gonna grab right there. So as you can see, this is what came off And I anticipated this just based upon what I saw last time I was in here. And this is why I'm wearing my full gear, is because I was gonna have to get in here and touch this stuff. See, I'm already taking little stingers there, but looks like some drone comb that is basically just filled with nectar. So I need to get my bee brush. That might help get rid of them a little bit more gentlier than my fingers. And this stuff, we can brush the screen. And even though some of it's uncapped, it's still probably good enough to eat, by the way. Alright, so I'm going to leave these here. I'm going to put this on just so. Keep those yellow jackets out. Right there. Yeah, you can donate to the insulation. Put that there. Actually, I'm going to take this with in case I got to scrape something. That there. All right, so we are back at the wax station here, and what we're going to be doing is I'm going to do an experiment with popsicle sticks. I'm just going to put about 2 dabs of hot glue, and I'm going to put these popsicle sticks on and basically put a decent coat of wax on, and see how that works. I also need to mark the frames with the year. So I have my blue Sharpie for that. And then with at least the plastic foundation, I've been marking with 2 dots to indicate which, not necessarily which side, but how many sides are undrawn. And then once one side gets drawn, then I will cross off one of the dots. And then cross off the other one when it becomes drawn out. For instance, this side's drawn for the most part, or that they've started to mess with it. So I would have crossed that dot off. And then this side, because they have started drawing it, I would have crossed it off as well. If it was completely untouched or just a little up here, I would probably not cross it off until they start coming down in the middle more. Alright, so I'm just taking some wax here, just coating this stuff, going a little bit down the edge here on both sides. Getting a nice coat of wax. Hopefully that will encourage them to be good little bees and cooperate with the beekeeper, who has no idea what he's doing with this experimental expedition of mine.
Oh, they're leaving.
for some reason, I have a feeling that the string is gonna work better because it's gonna go the entire length of this. And it's not sticking out so far. But essentially that's all what a foundation is just a starting guide or a little starting strip. Those go the entire length of this though. But hopefully by me putting some wax on here, it will again encourage them to continue that out. And it just drips some wax on my pant leg and it feels good. Okay, this is the 10th frame here. We are gonna right there. And we're gonna take this back, put them back in there, and grab 10 more. So we'll see you back over there. All right, we are back after putting our guides on with the wax coating. Insert some of these here. Now, as far as what was where, I'm not really too concerned. There was no brood in here or nothing, so I do try to get somewhat accurate, and then also a plastic foundation in between each foundationless. This is the one that was towards the back here, so I'm going to keep that consistent, and I'm going to put a foundation in. This is what I want. Better comb. Get out of the way, little girl. Okay, now before I put those three in, I'm going to need to clear out some more space here. So that's what we're going to do. They're just attacking the honey on here. And again, these frames are just full. Okay. Basically, just gotta do it. Oh my gosh. Oh. Look at that. Just full of dripping honey.
Looking for your queen?
Caps. I haven't been. I would be surprised if she's passed all this honey here. But look at all that. I mean, they definitely...
Now, did you mark this queen already?
This queen was already pre-marked when I got the nuke. One thing about these gloves is it makes it very difficult. I'm gonna scrape this unruly comb off. Now I would be really hesitant to do this without my gear on, but I mean, I probably would have taken 20 stings right there. They definitely do not like it when you do this kind of stuff. And this is lambskin. It's not like cow hide where you're gonna get the most leather-esque protection. But they're not trying to attack me. If anything, it's gonna be because my fingers got in there and squished one and yeah, get out of there, you know. This next one's gonna be nice and big as well. And this is a wired foundationless frame right here. Calm compared to what I was anticipating. But again, this is gonna be a nice one here. Okay, so now we're getting more into the brood portion of wild comb. Again, this is all honey, which is absolutely amazing. This is way more than I thought I would be looking at, for sure. Let's see. So we are getting closer to brood. I just want to make sure the queen didn't go for a day trip somewhere over here. And one of the reasons I'm doing this is a nice drone. It's good to see a bunch of drones. I want to be able to get in here and not break comb off all the time, as if what basically happens now. So again, this was a wired foundation. So, just out of curiosity, I got 1, 2, 3, 3.5, 4, 5, 6. So far, 6 full frames of deets of honey, which is probably enough. I gotta start getting a little bit careful because that queen is in here somewhere. And I do have to get the queen clip, because when I do see her, I'm going to look at that. They won the Plinko game. Went right down the middle. Make them happy. Stay. That,
holy. That.
Okay, so that's some nice brood stuff there. This is when you hope the queen is, you know, quickly found and does not end up on a piece of comb like that. That ends up chunking off. Good thing is it's capped, so I will be able to salvage it. And this drone comb here, we can not worry about, but I do again want to look and there's a bunch of eggs, so of course she's potentially close by. And these eggs are probably a good day old or two. You can tell by the, they're not straight vertical anymore. They're laying down a little bit, probably at a 45 degree angle roughly. And that's just based on what I've heard. They tend to be straight up, and then as the 3-day incubation period goes by, they tend to lay down and become more flat before they hatch. So get rid of this. Actually, what we'll do is shake these off. There's some drone comb right here, some drones, and then some honey there. So I'm gonna just put that in the honey bin, and I'll figure out exactly what I'm gonna do with it after. Now, all these open cells here have eggs in them, so she's doing a mighty fine job there. Now, this hive I have not robbed from. I have not split. I have not done anything really to weaken it, other than a mite count. One thing we also need to keep our eyeballs peeled for, which you can see on here, is this queen cup here. And there's no egg or anything in it. But that's just something I need to keep an eye out for, because you don't want to miss anything. Now, they had plenty of room in here, but now this, what I'm going to do is, I'll probably take and put in a frame. And I don't know what I'm really going to do with it right now. I think I'll just keep it here for now. It's fine where it's at. Look at all, within just a few minutes, they're all... coming up here. This thing is covered in honey. I don't blame them. That sun is just in a terrible spot for trying to view anything. There's a bug. Oh, wow. Okay, so they have a lot of comb down there I really need to get to, but I'm doing a quick over here to check for my queen. Just set it down or hold it or something real quick, because I'm gonna need it here in a minute. Unfortunately, the white dots on these queens have not been that great to find.
Are you going to stick that one or leave it?
What?
Nothing.
Can't hear you.
It's fine. I answered my own question.
Some of the stuff like this stuff, I don't have enough rubber bands, so it's just gonna...
I mean, I have that elastic stuff you can look at when we're done. You might be able to put on another frame.
Just shake out all the nectar. They'll get it. Put it over here and they'll rob it.
how they really made this entrance interesting. It's like a triangle. You should come down and take your phone and
walk them around.
You see it? I have a feeling once I get rid of all this burr comb, if I come in like a day or two to look for her,
you'll find her.
It will be a lot easier. Because this is all honey and. Honey and pollen on the edge here. Some capped cells there. Okay.
You got what you need?
So far, we've got a full box with probably a bunch of robbing.
Okay, I'm gonna.
String this one as well.
So that one's gonna have double? How many more frames do you have in the barrel?
Like two or three.
Okay. They getting ya?
Oh, wow. Oh.
Some people like that.
I don't want to shake these off because a lot of nurse bees on these now. Gotta get this done. We'll rearrange frames tomorrow. Got this crazy robin. I gotta get the brood back in here. Seen the queen yet, but
are you gonna string the last two frames or are you gonna just leave those ones?
What?
So are you gonna do the last two frames or leave those
yeah.
ones? Just have to keep your eyes out.
Sun is just terrible.
Right.
Thank you.
Hello.
Well, now that we have all 22 frames done with either a string or popsicle sticks and a couple coats of melted wax on there, we'll put them back together. It's a big robbing frenzy. I knew it was going to be chaos, but just needed to be done. And it is what it is. But let's get this done, huh? I know what I took.
What?
Three frames out, but only added two. I took that honey frame out. That's.
So you need one more frame?
That I'm missing. No, I have frames here. Okay. Putting this mostly drawn frame next to this brood frame here, and then I'm going to put this one next to that foundationless that they're drawn. We get the honey back to the back, other than the two or three frames they have in the very front. These foundation, I just put a little bit up here on both sides. We'll see if that does anything. They don't really like that, but that's okay. It gets the job done. Okay. Alright, all frames are in. Now I need to bring this over a little bit. Smoke them down so that they can go back.
Oh, hello. Thank you.
I don't mind if they get trapped on the outside between the top and the bottom, but I just don't really want to squish them when I put it on, and on the edges is where they like to hang out at.
Yeah, we're out of battery.
What?
The camera ran out of battery, but I got my phone going, so it's
really?
Fine. Yeah.
Okay, that concludes the inspection part. It was messy, crazy. We're gonna take care of the three frames here. I have a colony, I know where I'm gonna put them. And the burr comb and stuff that didn't have really honey in it down here, I'm just gonna let them finish robbing out, and they're going to town on it. Unfortunately, I did not see my queen, which makes me a little nervous. I'm probably gonna wait till tomorrow when they settle down, and then I will go through them again, and I won't have all that crazy burr comb to deal with, and I'll be able to just go frame by frame and being, you know, careful to spot her. Let's see, comb out of there.
Are you gonna do the mite wash tomorrow then?
Nope, I already did the mite wash.
Oh.
I'm going to count that. I did see two in there, just quickly looking, and I don't know if there's any more. So gotta let these girls calm down a little bit. But surprisingly, they are not feisty. They're not really that mad. They are bearding pretty good over here. Fan them, go back into there. I do have an opening, so any bee up top above the top cover will be able to get back into the colony. I'm gonna let that sit there until night or whatever, and or maybe I'll grab it. I don't know. All right, see you soon. All right, American's Bee here again, and we are done wrapping up here. As you can see, they are bearding like crazy out here. We took out quite a bit of comb. I took about three combs worth of brood out that they had to cut off the frames that were on the bottom. Put them in some other colonies to help them out. And I did take a little video of that, so see if I can throw that in there. This is normal. We disrupted their colony quite a bit, so their airflow is definitely back to day one. And we took some honey and we strained it, and we probably got probably close to a quart out of that so far. We'll see tomorrow when we take care of it. Unfortunately, we did not see the queen. I looked, but I was not going to spend all day because it took a few hours to get done, unfortunately. And I just didn't want to risk having to brood out longer than what they were. So we've got all the frames either with popsicle stick or some string with a good coat of wax on the bottom. And hopefully that will work and encourage them to draw it out straight. Only time will tell. I may get in here tomorrow once they settle down and they get back in there. And I may do some rearranging. I took one frame of honey out that was just a wire foundation, or foundationless with wire. And I put it in the freezer to save for a rainy day, and then I put a plastic foundation in. I may take a little more out, maybe one more frame, and move it to a different colony or something that's low. I know I have one that's low. We'll see how that goes. I think they're going to rebound very quickly. You can see there's a lot of bees here, and these are probably just all the returning foragers there. So it's interesting when they, right at the entrance here, they had two combs going this way and then one kind of in the middle. It was a really weird entrance that they did. Hopefully they don't redo that. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you got this far, I do appreciate it. And hopefully you had a couple cold beers or a glass of wine to enjoy it. Take care. American Bee.